Bladers, this is Bladers EX back with another video. I'm here with the unboxing of First Uranus. Now apparently this thing is the first and the only Superking stuff that I've ever got, so I've never really had anything Superking related before and this is the first one. I got this as a prize for securing the third position in the Beyblade Burst Elite Grade Tournament Super Sparks by IBA. You can see that the box is entirely black and white and there are no colors, which means that this is a limited edition release by Takeatomi. Whenever Takeatomi releases something limited edition, then either they make the blocks entirely black and white out, or they don't really do anything, it's just a normal brown cardboard box with Japanese written on that. So the name of the bay is First Uranus, and it is known to be the bay that Lane owned before he got Variant Lucifer, or he upgraded or something like that. This thing contains of only the layer, like not even the chassis, just the layer. And this is why the packaging is also very small. So enough with the initial description, now let's just move towards the overview of the box. So as you can see, the box is pretty small, like it's this big, because as I said, it just has the layer and nothing else except it. It's got no chassis, it's got no driver, it's got no disc, just the layer and the Superking chip. Starting from the front side, first of all, we see a Beyblade logo, classic. Then we have some Japanese written over here and here. I guess this means Superking. I don't really know. I'm a noob at Beyblade Burst. Then towards the left, we have a Korokoro logo, which means that this is a Korokoro special edition release. That is why it's a limited edition. Then we have the most eye-catching thing on this box. And this is the graphic of First Uranus. So this is how the layer and the Superking chip looks like together. Then towards the bottom right corner, we have a graphic, a picture of Lane Valhalla, the supposed owner of this bay. Lane Valhalla, I hope that's the correct pronunciation, because I don't really know much about this character as well. B-00. Towards the left is Superking over here and B-00 over here again. Towards the right of the box, we see three. I don't really know what this means, really sorry about that. Then towards the top of the box, we see a Takeatomi logo right there, and I don't know what's this, and this maybe means that it was released in 2020. Yep, it was released in 2020. Towards the bottom also, I'm pretty much a noob at all this. Maybe these are the instructions or something like that. Towards the back of the box, the first thing that we see is a recommended combo by Takeatomi. So I guess this combo is supposed to be First Uranus, Wheel Mobius and 1D chassis. I have none of these parts except for this and this now, which are in the box. But this is the combo that Takeatomi has recommended for this layer. I guess there was another revelation in anime which showed that the combo that Lane used with First Uranus was another Mobius and 2D, and that 2D was different. Like the 2D that Variant Lucifer has, it has those six rubber tongues which just pop out whenever it spins at high RPM, but that specific disc, or I'm sorry, the chassis that they showed, it wasn't really having any of those tongues, so it was quite vague. Like, why did they even show it when they never released something like that? Anyways, towards here we can see two of the main characters of the Superking anime. I forgot their names. I guess one was Hikaru and the other one was Hyuga. I hope that's the right pronunciation, because as I told, I'm a noob at Beyblade Burst, like the newer season, so yeah. Towards the bottom, I guess these are cautions or hazards. I don't really know, because I don't know Japanese.
Cry, kid! Cry!
Stop it! Get some help!
Unfortunately, I do see some English stuff over here. First, we have a made in Vietnam. And second is do... let's just pretend that I never read that. So with this, the overview of the box is over, and now open this box and just like, I just got a hangnail. Screw this box. I don't know what the hell is coming out of here. Oh my gosh, is this empty? Oh wait, oh wow, okay, now the box is empty. Someone is messaging me on Instagram, which I'm not gonna check. And oh, okay, wow, that is kind of pretty. Let me just rip off the tape like that. Man, I'm a monster. So this is all the stuff that I got. Let me just put that aside. So this is the layer and the Superking chip without any chassis. We have stickers underneath and this instruction manual, and I don't really know what this is. So the bay kind of looks huge, like I'm not used to Superking stuff, and this looks huge, like huge.
Not dagger dead, dead.
What's this supposed to be? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 20, yay! I gotta be careful with the pack so that I do not really cut off the stickers or the instruction manual. And I didn't. Let's just take everything out. Ooh, man, this is smooth. Instruction manual. I'm not able to open it. Okay, here's a crying kid again. Crawl! And I guess this shows how to place the stickers, which is gonna be one hell of a menace. Look at the stickers. this is gonna take ages for me to put. I cannot really get it in. Let's just leave it aside. So this is the main thing that we got, the layer or the base, whatever it's called, without the chassis. And it kind of looks bland, like plain white and gold, and without any stickers, obviously it's gonna look like that. But still, this thing is huge. As I said, I'm not really used to much Superking stuff. Like the biggest base that I have in my burst collection is, first of all, I've had this Archer Hercules. This is the widest one, and then wider than Archer Hercules, I've got Nightmare Longinus, and this is bigger than both of them. So yeah, I mean, this Superking base are huge, and I should be ashamed to say that I have no idea how to take this off. Like, I can see this, and why am I recording myself figuring out, trying to insult myself how to do this? Is it like, oh, okay, fine, I just, okay, this is cool. This is the main stuff that we get. First that comes to our hand is this Superking chip core, I guess that's what I'm supposed to call it. And this one is black in color with some golden indentations, and such indentations by which I cannot really interpret what it means. Now the main menace is going to be how to put that back in the chip. Yeah. Oh yeah, I did it! This is the Superking chip, and I cannot really say much about it other than how awesome it looks. I don't know why, but to be frank, to me it looks a lot similar to the Superking chip that Radiant Lucifer has. Like, I don't know why. Like, I've seen the chip and it really reminds me of that. And maybe that's because it was Lane that owned both the base. Because I don't really think that Uranus and Lucifer are supposed to have anything in common, like in mythology and stuff. Wasn't it supposed to have the teeth? Where are the teeth? Or maybe it's the chassis that's supposed to have them. Maybe the... I don't know. Initially, like when I just took out the packet and saw it from outside, I thought that these golden stuff was supposed to be metal. But apparently it's not metal, it's just colored plastic. And we have this golden face and two green eyes over there, and of course the Superking core, that's what it's called, maybe. And I guess that's all about it. This is the layer. It says R over here, so maybe that means that it's a right spin layer. First look that I'm having at it, it kind of looks bland, like plain white, but I guess it'll look much better with the stickers. And holy hell, where did I put the stickers? Yeah, here they are. So it's gonna look much better with the stickers, and obviously I've seen this layer with the stickers and all, like online on internet and stuff. Its shape is like Super Hyperion, like a lot like Super Hyperion. And I know that it doesn't have any connection with it. Maybe it was just a fluke by the creators, or I don't know. Shape looks quite jaggedy, like an attack type. We have two big blades over here and then two smaller blades over here, and then these big blades are also divided into one smaller and one big blade. So this, I don't know why, unpopular opinion, but this kind of reminds me of a right spin's Y Longinus as well. I don't know why, because Y was also shaped somewhat like this, like the big dragon head and the small dragon head, and then these two in left spin, obviously. So I don't know how many people think that, but I certainly do. Now, how to place this? I guess that's how I took it out. And then, oh my god. Yes. Okay, so, hey, wait a second. I guess I didn't do it properly. Oh no, this is so damn hard. Okay, I guess now I got it. So this is the full stuff, all intact. And let me just be a little courageous and try to put on the stickers myself. I cannot even begin to express how proud I am of myself. Look at this. I've never done such a perfect sticker job on any bay before. And literally, First Uranus is like, I've stickered a lot of bays, but First Uranus was like one of the hardest bays to ever do the sticker job for, in my experience. This is the sticker sheet. That's all that's left of it. All the stickers have been used. And literally, the stickers were so tiny that I had to use a toothpick in order to place them. And I'm also not very good with small things, like I'm not a micro artist or anything like that, but still, this was so hard for me and I did it. I'm so proud of myself. As I expected, the bay with the stickers on looks much better than when it was just plain white. I mean, the look has been elevated to some other level. I don't know if there's proper lighting to show the bay, but still, I guess it's perfectly visible. I would have done a test pin if I had a chassis that I could pair it with. But I don't really, as I told you guys, I don't really have any Superking stuff. So this is the first one that I've ever got. And that's why I don't really have any chassis to pair it with. And apparently without any chassis, the layers are incomplete. And they cannot really work. There are no teeth, nothing. So I guess we're gonna skip the test pin part. This was my unboxing and review of the B-00 First Uranus Limited Edition. Just the layer and the Superking ship. I did an unboxing after, I guess, almost 2 years now. Maybe exactly 2 years, but I'm not sure. But yeah, 2 years is like the about time. And that's a lot of time, because the last build that I unboxed, that I got NIB, was Archer Hercules. I just have it there at this moment. The parts are in my box. I don't really have it right now. So thanks for watching, guys. I hope you liked it. I hope I did well in this video, and I really hope that it pays off in terms of, you know. Thanks for watching. CX out.